But of course, there are two metals left. Now, I have a sample of rubidium, and at the moment it's kept under argon gas, and it's on the glass at the bottom here. So it does not react with argon at all, and this is keeping it hopefully safe from the air. But watch what happens as soon as I take the lid off of this. As soon as I take it off, it's gone crusty, it's gone white, very, very quickly indeed. If I just sort of tap this about a bit, it sort of melts. It's reacting very quickly, and little sparks are coming off. We have the lights down, please. You might be able to see some of the sparks coming off. There we are. Okay, this is reacting violently with the oxygen from the air. As soon as it comes into contact with air, very, very violent. So rubidium is even more reactive than potassium. And of course, the final group member is caesium. And you can see, maybe, hopefully on the camera there, that this is actually liquid, because it's rather warm at the moment. So this is liquid, and again, I'm going to take the lid off. Oh, and as soon as I take it off, a little spark came out. And again, if we have the lights down, maybe we can see if there's anything left. Oh, there's a little spark there forming. Okay. It's essentially all reacted. It's gone already. So again, very, very reactive. This is the most reactive of all the metals. So there is no caesium left now, just this black oxide. Okay. Right, so this is why we don't find these metals in nature. They are so reactive.